So here I am once again, Steve Mills, live on my podcast, Warts and All. It's great to be back sharing with you some more tried, tested and proven ways you can grow your business. And today I wanted to talk to you about an area of business that I think is sadly not done as professionally as it should be, and that is sales. Sales is the biggest opportunity that you've got in your business. In truth, if you're committed to growing your business, then the only way of doing so that I'm aware of is to increase sales. Okay, you could reduce your costs a little bit by 5% or 10%, but the truth of the matter is, if you're really committed to growing your business, then you've got to be really committed to increase in sales. So my question for you today is really around how much effort you put into selling. And specifically, I'm talking about calling people. You know, we've got to have a pipeline. You know, it's great, you know, if you've got, you know, I don't know, £1 million sales and you only get 10 of those a year, and you know, that's great. But for the rest of us, what we've got to really do is stock up that pipeline. And, you know, I see so many people, when I ask them, you know, what's your system? What's your sales system? What do you do? They say, well, you know, an inquiry comes in and we follow it up by email, and then we phone them. And then what happens? And they say, well, if we don't get through, we'll phone them again. And if they don't get through, we'll phone them a third time. And if they don't, then that's it, because they're clearly not interested. And, you know, that's one way of looking at it. But the truth of the matter is that, you know, if you persevere, then sometimes you'll get rewarded for that perseverance. I know what it's like in sport, you know, that people take part in sport and they try and try and try again. They think they're never going to get there. Then all of a sudden something clicks and they go to that next level. And so that's really what this podcast's all about. It's about going to the next level. So what I'd like you to do, or what I recommend you do, is to start thinking about your system. What is your sales development system? So when an inquiry comes in, what happens? What happens then? After that, what happens? After that, what happens? After that, what happens? After that, what happens? And what happens right to the end? Is that a 5-step process? Is it a 10-step? Is it a 20-step process? Who knows? I know my good friend Peter Thompson always says that you keep going until they die or buy. Now, that may be a little bit, you know, strong. And I know Peter's, you know, probably saying that a little bit tongue in cheek. But the truth of the matter is that most people don't try hard enough. They come up with, you know, bullshit excuses, quite frankly, saying things like, well, I don't want to be pushy. No, that's not the truth. What you don't want is to just keep working hard at getting sales. And that's precisely what you should be doing. And so that's really the motivation behind this podcast. Get the system in place and then run the system. However, there's one other problem. And that problem is training. You know, you can have the best system in the world. If you're not very good at running it, then, you know, you're not going to get too far. If your words are not very good, you're not going to get too far. In other words, if you're not very good at selling, then you're not going to get too far. And so what you need to do, I believe, is to, again, develop a sales training system for your business. Now, I don't care whether you're a multi-million pound organization or you're a one-man business startup. You know, you need sales training. Now, how often should that training be? Well, for me, it should be every single day. Why, you know, if you're going to be good at something, you know, some of you know my background as an international table tennis player. And how I got so good was I started playing when I was about 13. And I literally took a day off when I was 18. I remember my day off. I remember my first day off. And that is 365 days a year. Christmas Day, Christmas Eve, Boxing Day, on holiday, you name it. I played table tennis. And so when you think about sales training. It's not a matter of, you know, going on a workshop one day, you know, and then ticking that off. Well, I've done that. I don't need to do that anymore, because we all know how much of that we're going to forget. You know, most of it is the truth. You know, statistically, 80% of what you learn on a training day, you forgot within 10 days. Certainly that you don't implement. So you should be training yourself every single day on sales. Now, how are you going to do that then? Well, it could be that you watch a YouTube video. It could be you listen to a podcast like you're doing right now. It could be that you buy into an online program and get that training live. It could be that you have internal training within your team, and your sales manager or sales director delivers that. But it should be every day. You know, every day from 8 o'clock to 8:30 for me is sales training. That's what I do. I do 30 minutes of sales training every day. And I've always believed in training myself. So, you know, what's your version of that? How often do you do sales training? Because if you're like 99.9% of the business people that I see, then you've probably not done any sales training for over a year. And yet you still expect to be good at closing, and you wonder why you're not managing to grow your business. Now, did you know that 80% of all businesses, actually 82.8% of all businesses, go bust in 5 years? I wonder why that is. And I wonder if they were really good at selling, whether that wouldn't be the case. You know, if you're selling stuff and you're making money, you know, are you really going to go bust? Probably not is the answer. So, you know, really take action on this one. This could make a massive difference to your business. Obviously, if you want help from me, if you want to find out more about what we do and how we could help with this, then please feel free to get in touch. Step one is to go to my website, which is stevemills.co. Step two is to go to the page called the strategy meeting and book yourself a free, no obligation, one-to-one meeting with me. And that could be delivered either in our office in Portsmouth, or it could be delivered online, or indeed on the telephone. So either way, go and sign up. That's www.stevemills.co. That's .co, not .com and not .co.uk. We're a .co. Okay, so thank you ever so much for listening, and I look forward to speaking to you again soon. Thank you.